Hey everybody, Danny Maude here. Thanks for joining us. If you are finding that with these clubs, the irons specifically, you aren't generating enough distance from them, you aren't striking them consistently, and the balls are going everywhere, then you're in the right place. A few years ago, I created the Catapult Method, which is literally transforming the way golfers strike all their shots, not just their irons. And I want to share with you exactly what it is in this week's golf lesson, because I know that if you get this right, you will learn to strike your irons effortlessly. You'll start to strike them more consistently, but in a way that will work around you, no matter your age or ability. That's what we're going to cover in this week's session. Before I do though, look, if you're new to the channel and this is one of your first videos of mine, please consider subscribing. Press that little bell button, next subscribe button, you get notified every time I release a video. Plus, if you don't have to remember a thing, in the description box below, I'm going to put a downloadable practice plan completely for free. Just take it away and enjoy. Right, let's get started. Now, I'm really, really excited because I absolutely know that this catapult method could really, really help not just your irons, but your woods too. So what is it? How is it going to help? Well, let's start with what you're going to need to be a great ball striker, not just with your irons, but also your woods too. Great ball strikers, they hit it a long way, don't they? So you're going to need some form of generating a lot of speed, but in an effortless way, a way that works with you and your body. We don't want to be causing injuries. But with speed, there's no point having a lot of speed if you're hitting it everywhere. If you're hitting it over the fence, over the trees, you know, all those kind of things, you need to generate accuracy and strike too. If you're striking the ground behind the golf ball, that's no fun, even if you're generating a lot of speed. So how do you do that? Well, look, we know speed, look, we need club head speed. This club needs to be let go. If you don't let the club go, you don't generate speed. That's the number one thing I see with most golfers. They're nervous. They're trying really hard. They don't let go. I'll show you how you can do that. But then the two real key ingredients here is this. You need to get the handle ahead of the ball at impact for ball striking, and you need to have control over this face. How do you do that without thinking of a million and one positions and at speed in probably about 1.5 seconds? Well, let me show you a simple way of seeing the catapult method and how it can help you. The catapult method will help you get what I call is a delayed hit. A delayed hit on the golf ball is one of the major secrets to generating all those three things I've just talked about. So, give you a little analogy that I was out with my little girl literally a couple weeks ago in the garden, and I'm holding her hand like this, and I'm gonna catapult her. You probably know the game. You've probably done it before with your kids, so watch this. I'm holding her arm, and I'm literally gonna catapult her. And what happens to her, right? She starts to go slinging. She loves it. She starts flying, doesn't she? And she's giggling away. She's generating speed. Now, is she running? Is she running? She generating that, or is it me? It's me, isn't it? I have forced her, I have catapulted her and forced her to speed up and run. Yeah, I don't stand there and she doesn't run. I do it. How have I done it? Well, watch this. The first thing is this. Did I do it with my arm? No, there's just no, I could, but that wouldn't be fast. We could do it, but it wouldn't generate any speed. My arm is relaxed, my shoulder's relaxed. What am I doing? I am using the ground. I'm turning away from her. I'm turning away whilst this is hanging back. And as this hangs back, it lags behind, and then I sling her. And that's the catapult, yeah? So what is it? She's delayed. She's delayed. As I turn away, she's delayed. That delay then helps to create this catapult. So you try that for a second. You can imagine that. Just literally try. Just get a sensation of that. So what does this delay do? It not only generates power though. How does it help you with ball striking? Well, watch this. We want the handle ahead, don't we? Yeah? If you are struggling with your ball striking, your consistency, then your chances are you haven't got a delayed hit. You have an early hit. You're in a hit position where you're hitting here. You're hitting here. This is an early hit. This gets the head now throwing at the golf ball here. You get into flicky positions. I see chicken wings. I see hit ground behind the golf ball. I see weak shots, okay? A delayed hit, I'm turning. I've turned, look at this. Then this comes in, yeah? Delay, 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 whew, catapult. So how does this relate to golf? Well, the first thing you're gonna have to do in golf is this, and it's a tricky one. You gotta make sure that you're in a state to catapult. Your job is to feel the connection between your feet and the object here. I can feel Ava over here, and I'm gonna use my feet and my body to then sling her. I've got that connection. You'll have that too. We have to have the same connection with this golf club. How are we gonna do it? Well, you've gotta make sure that your arms and your shoulders are relaxed. Because you know what? If they're tense, there's no way of catapulting this. So the arms need to be relaxed. They're gonna respond to what I'm doing with the ground, and I'm slinging this motion. So let's look at this in action. I would just hit some balls, relaxing those arms, and seeing if you can basically, from here, look, sense that you're opening up and you're catapulting this golf club. If you wanted, you could just simply do this to start with, just get a feel for this. Pull the club, look, turn it behind, put it behind you here, and then simply just practice doing this. Turn, turn, leave it behind, and then get that sensation, whatever it is, as opposed to here, there. Look at this, I'm just gonna practice, just literally look, turn, and then feel that sling. Look at this, put it behind me, turn and sling it, right? So I'm using the ground to sling. Let's have a look at this in action here. So nice relaxed arms here, and let's start to sense that freedom and that catapult. Felt pretty good. Nice and easy. I don't know what it looks like on camera, but it feels pretty good. Look, what's that? Oh, nice, nice and close. So it's just a free flowing motion. But how do I get the accuracy with that? You know, how do I get that strike? Well, it all comes for free with the entire motion. Because look, you get, in order to, we've seen it before, the best players, they get forward onto their front foot. That's how they do it. But this comes by you connecting with the catapult, yeah? If you're over the golf ball and you're thinking of a million and one things, or you're nervous, and it's completely understandable, you're trying really hard, but you stood over the golf ball and your head's staying still and you're kind of trying your best and you don't want to make a mess up, you've got no chance of doing this. This is something where you're gonna have to really free up. You have to be willing to make the mistakes because you're gonna have to get that sensation. And if you, look, we all get nervous. If you're nervous and you're static over this, there's no way you'll move. So let's imagine this for a second. Let's say you slice the golf ball, watch this. I'm holding Ava here. Now, if Ava stood over there and I hold her, right? And then I try and catapult, where am I gonna swing her to? Over to the left-hand side. Yeah, this way, here. That's people who pull the ball, slice the ball. That's what you're doing. So what would I need to do? Well, notice where Ava was. I'm gonna put Ava over here. And I'm gonna bring her from behind me. Bring her from behind me, and then I'm gonna bring her around here as I turn, and I'm gonna then sling. She's gotta be over here for me to generate the speed and the arc to hit it beautifully straight. If she's over here somewhere, if you're this person who's still very static and you're just doing this and using your hands and your arms too much, you'll never be able to generate the catapult in the first place. So generating that speed, generating that effortless motion will be massively important. But the question is, how do you get the accuracy too? Well, we've just given you a little hint. Directions you swing will make a big difference to this. What you can do is grab maybe an old shoe box, an old club box works to grab. I've got a couple of boxes here. And all you can do if you really wanted is literally put a couple of boxes down like this, okay? And use this as a simple guide. So when you're catapulting it, okay, it's sometimes difficult to feel this awareness. So I'm swinging back here and I'm gonna catapult this club through. If you catapult it this way, I'm gonna hit this box. If you're the slicer and you catapult it across here, you're gonna hit this box. So all it does is it helps you now start to regulate an arc. Now if I start smacking these boxes, it doesn't matter, there are only boxes out there, right? So we do this motion now, we start swinging backwards and forwards, yeah? Now watch, I feel my arms are behind and I'm turning and I am slinging. I keep going, I don't stop, it's a delayed hit. Watch this, I don't, oh, the ball's there, hang on, I've got to stop and hit it. That's an early hit, that will get you flicking it, weak strikes. You have to be brave. Keep going, pass the ball. I call it around, watch this, get around the corner. Here, you turn it, so then you've got a delayed hit. Now we're all open, like a tennis shot almost, to then drive and smash that ball with accuracy and with power. So, let's have a look at this in action now. Get it quite close to the boxes here. Give myself some feedback. Make sure it's all lined up. Let's have a look at this in action. Didn't quite strike that one actually perfectly well. Is he gonna get there? Pretty good, couple of pretty good shots. So that is the kind of premise of the catapult method. It will hugely help your ball striking, it will hugely help your speed. It will hugely help your accuracy. Let's summarize what it is. Just imagine, get somebody to kind of get a sense of this. The person, it's a delayed hit, it's a catapulted hit, right? So get someone, hold them by the hand, put them behind you, and then imagine what you do with your body to then sling them and get them flowing out onto this circle. And that's the other thing. Look, when I'm swinging this club, I don't pull it down. I don't do this. I'm not pulling them in here. I'm literally catapulting this club out onto the circle. This is another reason why we create the accuracy in this shot. Yeah? If I'm pulling down my arms and trying all this kind of stuff, it's inaccurate. It's also not very powerful. So just imagine that. Now what I'll do is when you're with somebody, hold them in different places. Put them over here and then try and do it. Notice where you'll swing them. Put them behind you here. Now try and sling them. Feel these motions. You will get a real connection with what is the golf swing. If you're right-handed playing golf left-handed, no problem. Hold the person in your left hand. Do the same thing. It's the same situation. You're gonna feel what you need to do to catapult this golf club. It's gonna require you to let go. It's gonna require you to, you know, maybe fail a lot, yeah? But you can do it, you really, really can. And if you do, look, I've had hundreds and hundreds of students come through me doing this, and it's life-changing for them. It really, really is. They're out stuck in a million positions, they're achieving what they wanted, and they're doing it in an effortless way, no matter the age or ability. So I really, really hope you give it a go. If you do enjoy it, please give it a thumbs up. Maybe share it with one of your friends. Remember, you don't have to remember a thing. There's a free practice guide in the description box below. And if this was one of your first videos, consider subscribing by pressing that bell button. But until next week, have a great golfing week. Remember, there's a practice guide in the description box below. You don't have to remember a thing. Till next week, have a great golfing week.